I'm Professor Whitlock. I teach humanities at Porter Campus here at PHSC, and I'm just reaching out and saying hi. I know we're all feeling a little disconnected right now, and it really helps me to see your faces online, and it reminds me that we're a community. Even though we may not physically be in the same room together, we're still a community, and you know, I'm confident that we're going to find ways of staying connected. It's going to be a really innovative time for all of us. And I hope that first and foremost, I hope everyone's taking good care of themselves, and that you're really looking after your mental health, and that you're looking after your physical health, and eat as healthy as you can, get exercise, and just take care of yourself and your loved ones. And that's the first priority. But I also want to encourage you to really make the most of this time. I mean, we're going to be stuck at home a lot. Let's use this as an opportunity. I know I personally feel better when I put my mind to something and I do something constructive, and I find that it keeps me from worrying too much. And I encourage you to do that as well. And that I think that humanities, even though, you know, I'm sure that there are a lot of interesting discussions going on right now in biology classes. I know my husband teaches biology, and so this has been a really interesting real-world experience to follow, but in the sciences. But I also think that this time is really relevant to the study of humanities. I'm sure many of you have taken humanities. Maybe you've had humanities in my class, and if so, hi. There may be many others of you who are wondering, what is humanities? What is that subject? And it's very similar to art history, actually. But specifically, it's looking at humans. It's trying to understand humanity and human culture, mostly through looking at art. And I've one of the things that I've been noticing these past few weeks on social media is that there's a lot of art. People are sharing at this time where people are feeling very tense. People are looking to art. There's all kinds of opportunities to go on virtual art tours, and they're performing live operas, live streaming for people all over the world to watch. So people are turning to the arts right now, and I think that's often been the case in human culture. We use art to help us cope, you know, to help us feel better, but we also use art as a way of making sense of what's going on in the world and to kind of help us move forward. So one of the topics that we explore in my class right off the bat is we have a discussion about what makes humans unique, what makes us stand out from other living things. And one of the big conclusions from that discussion is that humans are adaptable. We're very adaptable to changes, and we find ways of collaborating, of connecting, of working together as a team to solve difficult problems. That's something that humans have historically, had working in our favor. And it's one of our keys to survival. I'm confident that we are going to find innovative ways of staying connected and getting through this situation and adapting. I really have a growth mindset about this situation. And for those of you who are familiar with that concept, I encourage you to really have a growth mindset and to approach this very challenging time. You know, yes, there's a lot of disappointments, but there's also a lot of opportunity for personal growth and for redefining and reshaping your priorities. And I think that, Dr. Jones described this time as a reset, and I just love that. Yay, Dr. Jones, because I feel like this is a good time for us to reset our minds and to really focus on what's important. So that's all for me for now, but I just wanted to, again, remind you to please take care of yourself, please take care of each other, and be safe.